Good day from Chem Help ASAP. This video highlights the Karplus equation, which shows the mathematical relationship between an observed J value and the dihedral angle between two neighboring vicinal hydrogens. Across the top of the screen is the general form of the Karplus equation. The J value is a function of the dihedral angle between two hydrogens, and the equation incorporates trigonometric functions. For a dihedral range of 0 to 180 degrees, you can see that the observed J value can vary widely from as high as maybe 15 Hertz and all the way down to 2 Hertz. Note that the equation does have different parameters, A, B, and C, which are changed based on the exact type of molecule being studied, so the shape of the curve can vary from one type of molecule to another. For simple alkyl chains, let's draw a butyl chain here. You have free rotation about all these carbon-carbon bonds. If we think of butane as a Newman projection, let's draw it. We can recognize that the dihedral angle can constantly change as the bonds rotate. So the J value between these two neighboring hydrogens can be variable. In practice, the value that we observe in an NMR spectrum is an average from all the conformations. A typical J value for split hydrogens on an alkyl group is 7 to 8 Hertz. Let's see an example. In the lower left is propanol. Let's focus on the CH2 group in the middle of the molecule. These hydrogens have three neighbors on the right in the methyl and two neighbors on the left in the other CH2 group. These neighbors are not identical, so their J values may not be the same. However, since this molecule has a simple alkyl chain, all the neighbors, all five, show essentially the same magnitude of coupling with the middle CH2 hydrogens, and we can consider all five neighbors to be identical. Let's write out Pascal's triangle up to five neighbors. 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 4, 6, 4, 1, 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1. That's it. Five neighbors. The n plus 1 rule says the multiplicity should be 6, a sextet. The predictive relative intensity should be 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1, based on Pascal's triangle. That's roughly what we see here. The J value, or coupling constant for this sextet, is about 7.4 Hertz. Coupling for alkyl chains is very predictable. How about other types of molecules? Here are some rings and alkenes. All of these are notable because the conformation of the molecule is more rigid, so the dihedral angles between the neighboring hydrogens is relatively fixed, and the Karplus equation becomes more relevant. For neighboring hydrogens on an aromatic ring, the dihedral angle is fixed near 0 degrees. And a typical J value for these two hydrogens would be 8 Hertz. For alkene hydrogens, let's focus on this CH on the right. This hydrogen has two neighbors. One is trans across the alkene. The other is cis. The dihedral angle of the trans hydrogen is 180 degrees. The cis one is 0 degrees. With such different fixed dihedral angles, the J values are also different. Trans hydrogens often have a J value around 15 Hertz. Cis hydrogens have a J value around 8 Hertz. Unlike the alkyl example on the previous slide, all neighbors are not always equal. In this last molecule, a cyclohexane, this axial hydrogen has two neighbors, one axial, one equatorial, with very different dihedral angles. The coupling for the two diaxial hydrogens is about 8 Hertz. Hydrogens that are one axial, one equatorial give a J value of about 2 to 3 hertz. That is the story on the Karplus equation, dihedral angles, and J values. Please leave a like or subscribe. If you have a question or comment, please use the comments section. Take care.